What's going on, everyone? It's Justin here, and today I've got my last episode of the Back to School Season 2019, which is a student-themed desk setup tour. This setup essentially has all the fundamentals that a student would want to have, whether it is the compactness of it, but also keep in mind the fact that value is one of the most important things when it comes to a student setup. If you guys want to go ahead and check out some of my other Back to School episodes, including what's in my bag, a budget bag, as well as a living room setup tour, then I'm going to drop a link to all of them down below. And if you want to win one item from this video, just make sure you subscribe to the channel, drop a like on this video, and leave a comment down below, and I'll pick a winner when this video hits 3,000 likes. So the desk that I did go with is from Zipcode Design, and that is the Folkston desk. And I feel like this is kind of the smallest size that you should have for any desk setup, coming in at 41 inches in length and 21 inches in depth. Typically my preference is 24 inches in depth and 45 inches in length, which is a pretty common IKEA size. But if you just don't have the space, whether it's next to your desk or your wall, then this is one that I think is kind of the absolute minimum for a compact setup. The quality of this desk is okay, really nothing special, but I think it does get the job done in going with kind of a modern theme. So with the monitor of this setup, the one that I went with is the Dell S2419HN 24-inch 16:9 IPS monitor. The stand is definitely not the prettiest, and the screen is not the brightest, but I feel like the overall screen quality is very good for the price. I've been seeing it on sale a lot below $150 lately, which makes it a great price for any student, and it's great that a lot of monitors nowadays come in at much more affordable prices for what you're getting. I'm just not going to sit here and recommend a $950 5K LG display for a video perfect for students. The monitor itself has a 1,000:1 contrast ratio and a 5 millisecond response time, which should suit most needs pretty well. You're going to find all the controls on the bottom of the right side to navigate, and it makes things very, very easy. It also has two HDMI ports on the back, which is perfect for having a computer as well as a gaming console hooked up, as well as one 3.5mm output because it does not have a speaker. I really do like the fact that the bezels are nice and thin though, and at the price, I think you really can't go wrong with a Dell monitor. Because the monitor does not have a speaker, the one that I went with for this video is a Z207 from Logitech, and I think this is an option that is very good for most students because it is powerful enough without being too powerful, but you do also have the option to connect a phone via Bluetooth to stream music directly to the speaker as well. This total package comes in at the price of under $35. The peak power comes in at 10 watts, and the overall sound quality is pretty good for its price. Nothing too impressive, but definitely a very big improvement from internal speakers of a computer. And if you want to save another $15, you also have the option to go with a model that does not have Bluetooth capability. The sound quality I would say is good with the 2.0 design, but definitely nothing too impressive, and I think it is going to be a major improvement for many computers out there. If you're looking for a good computer mouse that can double as one that you use in your desktop setup as well as one that you take on the go, then a best option is the MX Anywhere 2S mouse from Logitech. This is kind of a little brother to the MX Master line, and you're able to switch between different devices using the buttons built into the bottom. You can get up to 70 days of battery life on a full charge, and for my size hands I find it very comfortable to use and the scroll wheel very nice, but if you do have larger hands then you might want to get something a little bit bigger. As for wireless charging pads, there are so many options out there now, whether it is in the cheaper spectrum or the more expensive ones such as the Google Pixel Stand or one from Belkin, but if you need something that you can simply just charge your phone at a respectable speed, then a good option is from Anker. This thing is literally $16, so just go ahead and plug it in, put your phone on it, and it will start charging right away. It has a tiny LED indicator, and it just comes with a USB cord, so you do have to get like a USB wall plug or just plug it into your computer. At the price point, there really isn't anything too special about it, but I feel like all wireless chargers essentially do pretty much the exact same thing. For any student studying desk though, you might want to also add a lamp as well, and although this isn't needed for every single person, I think you can find a good option at a pretty good price, and the one I have right here is from Aki. It is an LED light that has 5 lighting presets, whether it's cool, ambient, natural, warm, and golden, and also 7 different lighting settings based on the brightness. Although this entire thing is made out of plastic, the little touch capacitive buttons on the bottom actually do work surprisingly well. One thing that is very essential to any setup though is a pair of headphones that is comfortable, has good sound quality, and is very versatile as well, especially if you're a gamer. One great option is the Razer Kraken, and this comes in at a price point of $79 and is a very popular choice for a lot of esport pros. You've got a pair of 50mm custom tuned drivers for gaming, which give you great sound quality, clarity, and depth, and the bass is definitely there as well, which is crucial for gamers, especially in the 7.1 compatibility. This just gives you the total immersive surround experience. You've got a cooling gel infused ear cushion to reduce heat buildup over many hours of play, which is something that I find is an issue on a lot of different headphones. And there is also a unidirectional microphone that is retractable and offers great sound when it comes to talking to your teammates. I just think the comfort and build is very well thought out, and you can also wear glasses while being able to put these headphones on as well, no problem. The aluminum frame makes this headphone very durable, and I think it also looks incredible with this setup as well in the mercury white color. If you're looking for something a little bit more affordable though, then the Razer Kraken X comes in at a price point of $49. It is super light on the head and comes in at a weight of just 250 grams, which makes it great for listening to music or gaming as well. It has a 7.1 surround sound experience as well as a cardioid microphone, and it also has a hidden indented eyewear channel which allows you to also wear glasses while wearing this. If you guys want to check out both these headphones from Razer, I'm going to drop a link down below, and a huge thanks to them for sponsoring this video. The keyboard itself is a Logitech K380, which can also switch between three different devices, but it really isn't anything special. The keyboard itself is very simple. It's got the circular keys that are nice and tactile and pretty much get the job done for any productivity, and it comes in at a price of under $30. But otherwise, I really hope you guys enjoy this back to school themed desk setup tour, and I hope you guys have a great school year, and I'll see you all in the next video.